Northwestern School of Law, one of the principals of Global Lab at globallab.io. I want to thank Unitize and the Unitize team for being kind enough to have us host and co-host the regulatory day here at unitize.online. Got a really spectacular lineup for you. We've got four panels that we've curated that we think you're really, really going to enjoy. This is regulatory day, so we're looking at the regulations or the lack of regulations in some jurisdictions. And we're also looking at not only private crypto and blockchain projects, but also central bank digital currencies as well. Our first panel is on the DCEP, the Digital Currency Electronic Payment Initiative from the People's Republic of China, that when it's coupled with the One Belt, One Road Initiative, which is a 71-country-wide trillions of dollars investment and infrastructure development plan that's linked to the People's Republic of China, you can see the powerful potential and reach that the People's Republic of China ongoing work to be the global powerhouse in not just blockchain and crypto, but also artificial intelligence, 5G, supercomputers, quantum computing, all sorts of technologies. Increasingly, we're seeing the Made in China 2025 policy being a real game changer, and will change the way that we understand currencies. As we couple that with the Digital Currency Electronic Payment Initiative of the People's Republic of China, you'll see the incredible power that this new initiative will bring to the global economy and the integration of different supply chains and data informatics. When we hear from Professor Douglas Arner of Hong Kong University, an expert on DCEP and digital currencies generally, we'll learn more about that. Likewise, one of the two co-founders of the FinHai FinTech Study Center at Fudan University in Shanghai, China, Professor Michael Sung, one of the leaders behind the blockchain-related services network that's being paired with the DCEP. We'll learn more about how commercial industries can participate in the DCEP and how that's, again, going to be a game changer. And when we hear from our good friend Dr. Henry Arslanian of Pricewaterhouse in Hong Kong, we'll learn more about how digital currencies at a sovereign, state-backed level will change how crypto generally will be accepted throughout the world, especially with this new RMB-backed DCEP. It's an incredible game changer, as I mentioned, but also has an ability to displace the US dollar as a reserve global currency, or the reserve global currency, but also we're seeing a U.S. response, not just to Libra and this idea of a private and incredibly powerful digital token system, but the Digital Dollar Project that Christopher Giancarlo, a former chair of the Commodities Futures Trading Commission, who's also part of Unitize a little bit later today, is the architect behind. So it's a really exciting first panel on the DCEP as one of the central bank digital currencies. The DCE panel we're going to be presenting in a few minutes is moderated by Joshua James, also known as PonderJaunt in the crypto space, and he's one of the co-founders and a really important leading light here in Southern California with the San Diego Blockchain Forum, one of the co-sponsors and media partners of Unitize.online. A second panel is going to look at what California is doing. And in California, we've got some leadership in the areas of blockchain and crypto. We're going to be hearing a little bit later from Senator Robert Hertzberg, who's the Senate Majority Leader in the California Senate, and his colleague Ian Calderon, who's the Assembly Leader and a State Representative. Both of them together have been formulating incredibly important plans for California to take a leadership position in state-oriented, when I say state, not the sovereign state, but the states as in states' rights. And as the federal government tries to figure out what to do in terms of legislation and the SEC, we have a California response that we're going to learn more about. That panel is being moderated by Chris Groshung of CoinStructure and the San Diego Blockchain Forum. So we're really excited about that. The third panel that we're really excited about is with Professor William Ahl of California Western School of Law and a securities lawyer here in Southern California, with the Honorable Hester M. Peirce, one of the five commissioners of the Securities and Exchange Commission. Renominated for another five-year term, Commissioner Peirce has been called Crypto Mom by fans around the world for her leadership and her forward-thinking approaches to how crypto can be regulated in the United States and globally. So the third panel is a really important conversation and one of our keynotes, and we're really, really excited about it. And then finally, we're looking at other jurisdictions. We've looked at the People's Republic of China with our first panel. We've looked at what California is doing with states' approaches to the crypto space, and then the federal response in terms of the SEC as one of the regulating agencies for crypto, and then finally other jurisdictions moderated by our friend Mary Saraco from Settle Network out of Argentina. Mary is moderating a panel with Manny Rosenfeld from Israel, an expert on the blockchain space in that country. Also, Jason Xu, the former crypto congressman and legislator from Taiwan, and a regular participant in so many crypto conferences. We've also got Peter Deitis, a former BIS, Bank of International Settlements, economist, who's going to be talking about the SOV, which is a sovereign digital currency coming out of the Marshall Islands, an incredibly important experiment. And then finally, we're also going to be hearing from Renato Ubisi-Bloom, a Brazilian expert on all things technology, but as he would call it, a cliquezinho, a little click, and an anti-piracy expert, but also in the space of crypto, an emerging light for Brazil and the entire Latin American region. So this is the time when we need regulatory certainty, legal certainty, clarity. These are the things that help us plan our affairs. Innovation works. Regulators are sometimes late to come to the party, but sometimes they muck everything up. Luckily, we have leading lights like Hester Peirce from the SEC and a number of others whom you'll meet today to help guide what are institutions that are sometimes slow to react to these things. We've got legislators like Ian Calderon and Robert Hertzberg from California and others in Wyoming and Arizona at federal level as well, with different congresspeople taking on the digital dollar in the initial PPP, the third stimulus package that went through earlier in 2020 as a response to COVID and to stimulate the economy. We saw an initial legislative package that included a digital dollar. That project hasn't gone away. You'll hear more about that from Chris Giancarlo later in the regulatory day here on unitize.online. But what's important is that we understand that we're so far from regulatory capture, we're in kind of a Wild West situation still, combined with, because of COVID-19 and the two-year hangover after the party of 2017 and early 2018, a crypto winter. So how do we claw back? How do we make sure that regulations are in place to not only foment innovation and encourage capital formation, but also protect the investor? The ma and pa, the folks out there that could get taken to the cleaners by nefarious actors and no good nicks out there. So that's the purpose of regulatory day, to kind of look at the contours. Where are we? Where are the leading lights? What are the great sovereign projects where the state is making a comeback? The Marshall Islands, the U.S. under the leadership of the Honorable Hester Peirce, California with Ian Calderon, the Assembly member and the Leader of the House, and Robert Hertzberg, the Senate Majority Leader, and a number of other experts right around the world. So without further ado, let's get into our four panels. I want to thank Gabriel Casares, Emil Casares from the San Diego Blockchain Forum. I want to thank John Allen and Ronan Kirsch and Gabriel Yang from Unitize and the San Francisco Blockchain Week. I'd like to thank Deneen Dent and Coy Garrison from the Securities and Exchange Commission for helping us put together the panel with the Honorable Hester Peirce. And to thank all of you for not only walking through this day with us, but for sharing your comments with the organizers at unitize.online. You can always find us at the San Diego Blockchain Forum, sdblockchainforum.org. My thanks to the moderators, Chris Groshong, Bill Ahl, Joshua James and Mary Sirocco, thank you so much for leading our panels, and to our speakers, and to all of you. Enjoy the day.